In today's lecture, we are going to solve more problems on HCF and LCM in the exercise 6. Okay, see problem number 38. Pupils in a class can be grouped in 4s or 6s or 8s and no one is left over. Find the least number of pupils in a class. So see here, pupils means what? Students. Pupils means students in a class can be grouped in 4s. This is S, right? 4 and S, or 6 and S, or 8 and S. S means to indicate plural form, okay? 4s or 6s or 8s means the students of that class. If we want to make a group, of that student, which group we can make? We can make a group of 4 students and exactly group where possible. Or we can make group of 6 students. Then also exactly group were possible, and also we can make group of 8 students, and then also the group of that student, exact group of those students were possible. So such number of students were there in the class, okay, and no one is left over. Means after making group of 4 students or 6 students or 8 students of the total students, then no student were no one was left. Okay, means exactly group of 4, 6 and 8 were possible. Such number we have to find, and such least number we have to find. Understood means what? We have to find a number, I'll show just concept, number which is divisible by 4, 6 and 8. 4, 6 and 8 means it should, this number should be in table of 4, it should be in table of 6 and it should be in table of 8 also. Such least number we have to find. So this number means what? What is this number means? Which is divisible by 4, 6 and 8, all these 3 numbers, and it is least number. So it is nothing but LCM of 4, 6 and 8. Right? It is nothing but LCM of 4, 6 and 8. The number which is divisible by 4, 6 and 8. The least number which is divisible by 4, 6 and 8. It is nothing but the LCM of 4, 6 and 8. Okay? That means the whichever is LCM of 4, 6 and 8, that number we can divide into group of 4, and also we will divide into group of 6, as well as we will divide into group of 8. Okay? Not any other number is possible. And it should be least. That means it is LCM. Okay. So here, to find the least number of pupils in a class, least possible number which can be divided, which can be grouped in the 4 or 6 or 8, that is nothing but LCM of 4, 6 and 8. Okay. So to find the least number of pupil we have to find, LCM of 4, 6 and 8. 4, 6 and 8. Okay. Now see here, in this way I have told the concept. Okay, now how to identify immediately whether we have to find LCM or HCF, GCD, whether we have to find LCM or GCD. How to find C? If you observe there is word least, we have to find the least number. Least number indicate that it is least common multiple, that is lowest common multiple, that is LCM. So we have to find here LCM. If the instead of word least there is word highest or greatest or largest, then we have to find GCD, because greatest common factor. Okay, in that, if the word is greatest, largest or highest, we have to find the HCF or GCD. Okay. So these are just hint words, I am telling you. Concept you must understand. Sometimes this unit words may not be given. So in that case, if we know the concept, we can find the answer easily, we can understand, okay? So here see, as I told you, we have to find such number which can be grouped into 4 or 6 or 8. Such number means the LCM of 4, 6 and 8, okay? So let's find LCM by prime factorization method. Now see, here there are 3 numbers, 4, 6 and 8. Then also don't worry, I'll tell you how to find LCM. First, as usual, first find prime factors of 4, 2 2's are 4, correct, and 2 1's are 2. Then find prime factors of 6, 2 3's are 6, 3 is prime number, so 3 1's are 3, okay. Then find prime factors of 8, 2 4's are 8, 2 2's are 4, and 2 1's are 2, okay. So here we have found prime factors of 4, 6 and 8. Now, write this way, 4 is equal to 2 into 2, 6 is equal to 2 into 3, okay, 2 into 3, and 8 is equal to 2 into 2 into 2, fine. Now what we are going to do, see, we are going to take common factors. So, while finding LCM, and if there are 3 numbers, how to take common factors? See here. First, we will see common factor in all the 3 numbers. So, here it will see this 2, 2, 2, it is common in all 3. So, we will circle it, we will make box to it. Now, see, is there any other factor which is common in all 3 numbers? No. But, while finding LCM, again, I am saying, while finding LCM, if there are 3 numbers, then we can take common factor in any 2 also. Means, see here, this 2 is in factor of 4, or as well as the 2 is factor of, or this 2 is factor of 8. This 2 is common in 4 and 8. Out of this 3 number, if while finding LCM, if any factor is common in any 2 number, that also we can take. That also we can take, we can circle this way. Okay. Now this 3 and 2, these are not common, that are non-common, we can say. Okay, because here also no 3, here also no 3. Again, there is no 2, no more 2. So these are non-common factors. What we have done understood? This arrangement or this what the factor which is common in any 2 number, this we can take only in the case of LCM, not in GCD. So this keep it in mind. So LCM is equal to, now you know that LCM is equal to what? Product of common as well as non-common factors. LCM of 4, 6 and 8 is product of common as well as non-common factors. So first common factors will write these 2 into these 2 into non-common, remaining all non-common, 3 and 2, okay. So now 2 3's are 6, 6 2's are 8, 6 2's are 12, 12 2's are 24. So 24 is the least number of UP in the class. If you check whether 24 is divisible by 4, 6 and 8, you can check, right? 24 is in table of 4 also, 6 also and 8 also. So 24 is such a number which can be grouped into 4, 6 and 8. Or it is a least number which can be grouped into 4, 6 and 8. After 24, if you want next number which can be grouped into 4, 6 and 8, it will be 24 2's are 48. Okay, so in this way we have to find, as they have asked this, so we have found LCM of 4, 6 and 8. So the answer is 24, right? We can write here 24 is the least number of UP in our class. Okay, let's move forward for the next example. Problem number 39. The bits in red were counted in groups of 5, 8 and 10. Each time one bit was left over. How many bits at least are there in that grid? So if you compare these two problems, same, they are same. Here also the bits are in grid. Grid means bits means what? That like marbles or if you have seen bit of red means what? Necklace. And bits of necklace, bits of red means this way. Okay? This is bits, bits of red. Okay? Now see, this problem and this problems, problem is same, but little difference is there. What is that? See, when the bits in red were counted in groups, here also students were counted in groups, groups of 4, 6 and 8. Here also, these bits were counted in groups of 5, 8 and 10. 5, 8 and 10 means the number must be divisible by 5, 8 and 10. Okay? Each time one bit was left over. Here when students were counted, no one is left over. At that time we found LCM. Right? Exactly LCM, this number 24. Because no one is left over. Here when were counted. Number of bits were counted in group of 5 or 8 or 10. Group of, when the bits were counted or bits were grouped into group of 5 or group of 8 or group of 10. In at that time or every time while counting in group of 5 or 8 or 10, every time one bit was left over. Okay? So how many bits at least are there in that place? So there is what at least also in list. Here also list, that means by just reading the problem you will come to know that yes, we have to find the LCM. But not only LCM, there is one more arrangement we have to do. What is that? Left over. The bit was, one bit was left over when all those bits were grouped into group of 5, 8 and 10. So all the time one bit was left over. Means what? We have to find such number which when divided by 5 or 8 or 10, there should be remainder 1. Okay? So first what we will do, we will find LCM of 5, 8 and 10. LCM, and in that LCM, we will add 1. Okay? We will add 1 because when it is possible to left over 1, when it is possible, for example, this 24 will take. There is 24. 24 is divisible by 4, 6, 8. So exactly we can make group of 4, 6 and 8. Okay, but if instead of 24, if there is 1 is added, that means it is 25, then what will happen? See, 25 divided by 4 if you want to do. Then 4, 6 are 24, correct? 5 minus 4, 1. 1 is remaining. Similarly, if you divide 25 by 6, then 6, 4 is 24. Here also see, 1 remained. If you divide 25 by 8, 8 3s are 24, correct? Here also 1 is remaining. So when 1 is possible, remainder 1 is possible, when in LCM we will add 1. So first we will find LCM of 5, 8 and 10, and in that LCM we will add this remainder 1. Okay? So that will be the our answer. See now. This is only the difference between this problem and this problem. I think you have come through the difference and the concept also. See here. First we will find LCM of 5, 8 and 10. 5, 8 and 10. Okay, so let's find first prime factors of 5. 5 is itself prime number, so 5 ones are 5, okay? Then 8. 2 4s are 8, we have found there. 2 4s are 8, 2 2s are 4, and 2 1s are 2. Okay, then there is 10. 2 5s are 10, 5 1s are 5. Understood this prime factorization? Okay, let's move next. Write factors of each. 5 is equal to 5 itself. 8 is equal to, see here, 2 into 2. Why I have done this, I'll tell you. 10 is equal to, now 10 has factor 5, so this 5 I'll write first here because it is here, and then I'll write 2. Okay, fine. Now let's take common factors, and as I told you, as we have to find LCM, and there are three numbers. So why taking common factors? We can take common factor in any two number also. So see, first we'll check whether is there any common factor in all the three, in all the three numbers. No, there is no. So then after that we'll check whether there are common factors in any two numbers. So if you see this 5 is factor of 5 and 5 is factor of 10 also. So it is in 2, so that we can take common. Okay. Then see this 2 is factor of 8 and 2 is factor of 10. So that this also can be taken as a common. Okay, and these 2 and these 2 are non-common factors. So LCM of 5, 8 and 10 is, first we write common factors, 5 into 2 multiplied by 2 and 2, 2 into 2, that is 2 2's are 4, 4 2's are 8, 8 5's are 40. So 40 is the LCM, 40 is the LCM of 5, 8 and 10, this is not our answer. If we divide 40 by 5, 8 and 10, if we group 40 bits into group of 5 or group of 8 or group of 10, exactly groups are possible. No any bit is left, no any bit will be left over. But we have to find such number which when grouped into 5 or 8 or 10, there should be 1 as a remainder. 1 bit should be left over. So such number, to find such number, we need to add 1 in the LCM. So required number of bits is 40 plus 1, that is 41. 41 is the least number which can be grouped into 5, 8 and 10 and left bit 1. Okay. So how many bits are the least? 41 bit as the least. If you want to find next number which can be next, which should be greater than 40, which means next number which is which can be divided into group of 5, 8 and 10 and remainder is 1, which it will be 42 is 80 plus 1, 81. If you have any problem in this, you can ask me. Okay.